First, we got voice to the bottom of the sea. And then we got Sequest DSV.
Premieres 2 weeks from Wednesday on NBC.
And then we got The Last Resort, which was truly The Last Resort. See you on the other side.
You've been warned.
Shepard, position report.
Crossing the equator now, sir.
Your first time crossing the equator on the warship, Gracie?
Woo!
I recommended you for a naval command, Virginia. You have a wife. Go home. Start a family.
Firing. It's a direct order, sir.
I'm not going to annihilate 4.3 million Pakistanis without hearing directly from someone whose authority I recognize.
You are relieved of your command.
Line's dead, sir.
What the hell did you just do?
I've inbound cruise missile on our position. All hands, emergency team! Emergency team!
Space for impact!
We lost 12 souls in the attack. Let's get somewhere safe so we can all see our families again.
I got a fix on the boat who shot us, sir. It's the Illinois.
Our own people tried to sink us?
Betrayed by their nation.
No matter what you're telling the American people, you sank your own daughter's boat.
And cut off from a world that has gone to war.
Dad, it's me.
Sam, is that you?
It's me, baby. I'm okay.
I think I found our oasis, the island of St. Marina. Let's grab some sunlight, people.
They must build a defense.
This station and that sub parked outside, they all belong to me now.
Decide who to trust.
This is my island.
And take desperate measures against the threat of their own country.
The Illinois shot us up, damn near killed us.
White House said it was the Pakistanis.
And every other nation on the planet.
Everything we did was to stay alive long enough to get home.
Maybe this is home now.
Two birds hitting our way. P-1 bombers.
Hiding in the ocean is not going to stop them from bombing this town and all the people in it. We need to change the game. They need to understand I'm a man of my word.
Please believe in me. Please remember how much I love you.
I love you too.
I'm declaring a 200-mile no-man's land around this island. We do not obey a government that tries to murder its own. Test us and we will all burn. Together. You've been warned.
Last Resort. Coming to ABC.
Hello and welcome to another episode of It Could Have Been a Classic. And this week, we're going to be talking about 2012's Last Resort, an American military drama series that aired on ABC from September 27, 2012 to January 24, 2013. The series was created by Sean Ryan and Cal Gadjidusek and produced by Sony Pictures Television. On November 2012, ABC announced the series would be cancelled. Right. You know, after watching this yesterday, I was at the end of, I don't know, it truly was, I'm going to say it, The Last Resort. So it's about the nuclear sub, the Colorado. And they're on a mission And it starts off quite positive. There's some Navy SEALs coming out of Pakistan on a classified mission. The Colorado picks them up. And straight away, before all that happens, they're playing La Bamba. And it's quite positive. And the SEALs are on board. They're floating under the sea. And they get a message through. But it doesn't come through the normal network. It comes through the Antarctic network to launch off a couple of nukes and wipe out Pakistan, right? Because these SEALs had some kind of secret order to go in there and do something. But it's this order, it's not coming through the normal channels, and it's coming from the defense minister, or whatever they call it. It's not the president. The captain questions it. He can't understand why is it coming through a secondary communication channel. And they surface, well, they send up the transmitter, and they're picking up on Anna Montana and like normal American TV. And there's a bit of a dispute because some crew are going, well, you got to launch. And then you've got Patrick Stewart, who's the old sea dog. He served all his life on submarines, and he's like Captain Chaplin's mate. He's like, he's the cop. And he's saying, look, you've got to launch the nukes. He's going, yeah, but it's not come through the normal channels. And suddenly, like, they're speaking to this defense minister, defense secretary, and a tomahawk's been launched to take him out. And there it begins. You know, suddenly the sub goes further down at water, it gets damaged. And the entire American military is after them, and the sub goes rogue. Well, it's not. It's because what's going on in the meanwhile, another sub has launched two nukes and wiped out Pakistan. It's wiped out two big cities. And that's where it all starts, the conspiracy of what's going on within the US government and this submarine captain who has to basically take a stand. And he finds an island called St. Manique or something. And there's a NATO observation station there. And the submarine turns up and basically take over island. And it gets pretty intense because when the government, they take over the island and basically to send a message to the American government, He phones up the White House or whatever, and he launches a nuke, does the captain, Captain Marcus Chaplin, played by Andre Breger, who's a great actor, launches a nuke, and it goes flying over Washington, D.C. And they've sent two bombers to destroy a submarine. And he said, if you don't send bombers back, I'll nuke Washington. An old crew, and they're like the intensity is building all the time in this series. The music and the intensity, you're like, what now? What's going on now? And they turn the bombers back, and the nuke goes off 200 miles in the sea from Washington and New York. But everybody sees the explosion.
Firing, it's a direct order, sir.
I'm not going to annihilate 4.3 million Pakistanis without hearing directly from someone whose authority I recognize.
You are relieved of your command.
Line's dead, sir.
What the hell did you just do?
I've inbound cruise missile on our position. All hands, emergency team! Emergency team!
Place for impact!
So the, like, after being, like, you know, hit by a tomahawk and the submarine, Captain Chaplin's been removed. The XO, Scott Speedwell, the actor who plays the XO, he's in charge. The captain's in his cabin. The crew were all shitting themselves. A lot of emotion going on. And Robert Patrick's character, who plays like this long-term seaman in the submarine, he's against it. Some crew were... they can't understand they should have fired it. I mean, there's a lot of conflicts with crew. But Chaplin works out that there's an island with a NATO tracking station on it. And that's where he goes. And the submarine pops up. And then we get into the whole sort of drama of this series. And my God, we get a lot of drama.
Call command.
Command, this is NATO listening post St. Marina. We're reporting two tracks originating in the Indian Ocean. Are we shooting at Pakistan?
It's real.
Can't you do anything?
No, it's too late.
So they get to this island and they get to NATO tracking station. And these bombers are coming like I was on about earlier to destroy the submarine. They threaten to nuke Washington, D.C. And then we jump back to Washington and we start getting into this conspiracy that there's these people are in the government and they're all like, well, they've got visions that they want to take over the planet or build an empire. You never really find out the reasons why that you've got a corrupt president and his followers. They're going to turn America into like this totalitarian state. And the president has visions of empire, basically. But you don't really go into the whole conspiracy of this, which is quite annoying. And then every week it's like the Russians sending the Spetsnaz to pinch the submarine. And then you've got the gangster on the island, which I did like his character, actually. And he's in love with a woman that runs the NATO tracking station. They get drugged. They drop this drug in to knock them all out. And then they send in special forces. And then each week it's who's behind what. And then we find out the CIA operative on the submarine who's sabotaging it, but she changes the loyalties. The captain's losing the fucking plot. He starts looking, start finding out he lost his son. His wife died. His other son won't speak to him. You start to see some kind of sort of thing with him, you know what I mean? And then we jump back to the conspiracy. And there ain't really much going on. It's this woman who works for this defense department. She's the scientist that created a cloaking device for the submarine called Perseus. And you can't track it once this thing's on. And then we're suddenly like running around the island with half the crew want to kill the captain and knock him off because they all want to go home. And then it got ridiculous. There's some fucking episodes in this that are annoying, right? There's one where there's a bit of a standoff where defense secretary turns up with this advisor from warehouse coming to some kind of an agreement. And it all goes wrong. And that, the crew will be allowed to return home, give the submarine back and rest of it. And it's like you sat there thinking, well, the government sends all their families to go visit them all on this island he's took over. And then some general from Pakistan turns up because his country's been destroyed. And then threatens to kill all the family members on the ship to go see these people have got a nuclear submarine that took over this island. I don't know, because they come to some big agreement, but then the defense secretary gets a phone call, there's another submarine in the water, it's going to blow the Colorado out. Because they have this radar zone that's 200 miles, so they can track everything that comes within like near island. And then there's a showdown with the admiral's daughter, she's third in command. And she's trying to prove herself because some crew don't respect her. And she proves herself to defeat the submarine without taking any lives. And every week it's a lot of intensity. I mean, the fucking music is really melodramatic. You're like they're trying to force you into these intense submarine, like I was gonna say submarines in these situations. I mean, there's like Exo's in love with his wife. She gets kidnapped and she nearly ends up on island. He leaves the island to go fucking save her. The Navy SEAL, he feels guilty about what happened to Pakistan, but he was just being used by these awful people that have took over the government. And there's a lot going on, but you never really get much on this conspiracy. I wanted to know what the reasons were. What was the full agenda? I know that they wanted to sort of like become like an empire. So you don't know. You don't really find out that there's this like totalitarian lot of took over. And they're getting rid of people back in America, you know. But then the series got cancelled.
Bomber's 4 minutes out.
This is Captain Marcus Chaplin of the USS Colorado. You have two bombers bearing down on our position. In response, we have a bird in flight toward D.C. I'm sure you're reading it.
This is Curry. You're bluffing, Marcus. Initiate missile destruct immediately by order of the President of the United States.
Negative. If those bombers aren't turned around within 2 minutes, you have my word, that missile will detonate.
You're going to ask, could this have been a classic? Now, the series does conclude with sort of an ending where the conspiracy gets done. They get the evidence, the woman in America who's investigating with the exile's wife. They bring down the government. There's a scene where they get to the Speaker of the House. He's going to expose it in Congress and he blows his brains out in front of everybody, which I found totally fucking pointless. You know, I mean, this would it, because it got cancelled, the conspiracy, all of it, the long-term plan just got shoved down into a couple of episodes. I mean, you've got the Chinese turn up on the island. They want to buy the submarine. They'll protect them and give them the supplies and all that. The crew mutiny. And then sort of one of the crew members loses his plot. He steals the submarine. The captain's on board and he's going to nuke America because, you know, he's been hiding in the jungle or something because he got done for the crime on island. The gangster dude, he just got phased out. Like, he came less relevant. Multiple love affairs, conspiracy, flashbacks, melodrama all over the place, and highly intense situations. Now, the first two episodes of this really get you into it, and it is quite intense, but there is some bad episodes in here, like the paranoid when they send this drug in to incapacitate the lot of them. There's that whole time frame, 8 hours before, 60, you know, and it's nothing new. So, I've read some reviews on this. The Last Resort would have made an amazing 2.5-hour action-packed movie of the conspiracy and the situation. A really intense movie. And I can't understand why this wasn't turned into a film, because it would have bloody worked with this. Now, the actors in this are superb. But like I said, with it being cancelled, they just had to squeeze it down. Now, if this had gone to season two, apparently from what I've been reading, Captain Chaplin would have become a dictator on the island, you know, like a nuclear power, and lost the plot. And it would have been about bringing him down and undoing the conspiracy. But at the end, there is a conclusion to this, which is, in a way, is quite satisfactory. But, you know, somewhere, the conspiracy, you don't really know much about it. What are the reasons? Apparently, the president wants to become an emperor and build an empire and all this. Whatever it is. And the characters are strong people. Especially, I love Captain Chaplin. He's such a, like, intense character. The XO, he's all right. He's like the nice guy who's going to undo it all. But there's another conspiracy where there's another lot trying to get the nasty lot out and all this. And they need them to stay on the island with that submarine because they come beacon of hope for the world. So, Last Resort, are you a classic? You could have been a classic. You're going through. Why? Because if you'd have been a 2.5-hour movie, you'd have been fucking exemplary.